एनर्जी. सो टुडेज टॉपिक इज एंटी एड्रिनर्जिक्स. ओके, एंटी एड्रिनर्जिक्स. सो व्हाट आर एंटी एड्रिनर्जिक्स? सिंपली दे विल बी ब्लॉकिंग द एड्रिनर्जिक रिसेप्टर्स. दे विल बी इंटरफेयरिंग विद द सिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम. दे विल बी यूजुअली ब्लॉकिंग द सिंपैथेटिक नर्वस सिस्टम. ओके, now what, okay, remind me about the receptors for the adrenergic system.
Alpha
and beta. Okay, so we were having adrenergic receptors, right? Alpha and beta. Okay, if you talk about alpha receptors, so adrenergic receptors, so they were alpha and beta. Further, alpha was dividing into alpha 1 and alpha 2. Okay, beta was dividing into beta 1, beta 2 and beta 3, but we were not considering the beta 3. Okay, we will only talk about beta 1 and beta 2. Okay, in last class we have discussed about those drugs which were stimulating these receptors, either non-selective or selective. Okay, tell me one of the drug. Isoproterenol. Okay, beta 1, beta 2, that was too many. Beta 1, beta 2. Any other drug?
Dobutamine.
What was the function of dobutamine?
For
it was beta 1 selective. Okay,
acute hypertension.
Okay, what about alpha category? Okay. Alpha methyl dopa was alpha methyl dopa and clonidine. They were alpha 2 agonist. Alpha 2 agonist. So they will be pressing the brakes, right? Anyways, today we are going to talk about adrenergic blockers. Okay. So some of the drug we will be talking about that they can block alpha 1 as well as alpha 2. We will call them as non-selective. The drugs which will be blocking selectively alpha 1 or alpha 2, that will be called as selective alpha blockers. Same category in this one. If the drug which will be blocking beta 1, beta 2, they will be non-selective beta blockers. Or if they will be selectively blocking any kind of receptors, we will be calling them as selective beta blockers. Okay, some of the drugs we will be discussing who are having the mixed kind of action, so they can block alpha receptor as well as they can block beta receptor. In the last class we have discussed about those drugs which were stimulating alpha receptors as well as beta receptors. I discussed about those drugs. There were two drugs mainly. Name those drugs. Epinephrine and norepinephrine. So they were stimulating alpha receptors as well as beta receptors. Okay, fine. So everything will be opposite as compared to the previous class. Okay, so first of all we will be discussing about the alpha blockers, then we will be discussing about the beta blockers. Okay, so let's start with the alpha blockers. Fine. Okay, so if you talk about the alpha blockers, we are having two categories: non-selective, which can block alpha 1 as well as alpha 2. Okay, the other category is selective alpha blockers. Okay, selective alpha blockers. In the selective alpha blockers, either we'll be talking about the alpha 1, either we'll be talking about the alpha 2. Okay, either we will be blocking the alpha 1, either we will be blocking the alpha 2. Okay, fine. Now let's talk about the drugs which will be blocking the alpha 1 and alpha 2, and after that we'll be discussing about the selective. So what can be the benefits, what can be the advantages, what can be the disadvantages for these ones and these ones? So you should know about the locations. What was the location of alpha 1 receptor? Blood vessels. Okay, blood vessels, then kidneys, liver, eyes. Very good. Okay, so these were the locations of the alpha 1 receptors. Now I told you in last class that whenever you will be stimulating your alpha 1 receptor, whenever you will be stimulating your alpha 1 receptor, what will be the effect?
Vasoconstriction.
Vasoconstriction. In the beta 2 receptors are also present to blood vessels, if you remember. What will be the effect if you will be stimulating your beta 2 receptors? Vasodilation. Okay? Vasodilation. Great. Now we will be blocking the alpha 1. If you will be blocking the alpha 1, what will be the effect then?
Vasodilation.
Okay? If you will be blocking alpha 2 as well, because non-selective, they will be blocking alpha 1 as well as alpha 2. What can be the effect if you will be blocking the alpha 2 receptors? First of all, what was the location of alpha 2? Presynaptic neuron. So they will be applying the brakes. So noradrenaline will not be able to come in the synaptic gap. Okay, and sympathetic nervous system will not be able to activate in those cases. So we can use them in hypertension cases, right?
Also there in pancreas.
In the pancreas also, okay, what will be the effect over there? Beta 2 mainly, they can be present in the pancreas. Yeah, they can interfere with the insulin. In the last class, we had one question about that. And the patient was having diabetes and he was having the hypoglycemic coma, okay, and that in that case we were using adrenaline, okay, because of beta 2 effect also, because adrenaline can act on alpha as well as beta receptor. So for that time we were using that one. Okay, so what will be the drugs in category of non-selective alpha blockers? Shall I rub this? Okay, so what will be the drugs? Let's talk about them. So one of the drug is phenoxybenzamine. Okay, so that phenoxybenzamine, remember, that will be irreversible. What does it mean, irreversible? Which means if it will be blocking, first of all, it will be blocking alpha 1, alpha 2, both the receptors. Okay, second thing, if it will be blocking the alpha 1 as well as alpha 2, okay, you will not be able to recover them back. Okay, so what will be the last option? Those receptors, you can't recover them back. So new receptor has to be, overcome that situation. Okay, and that will take about 24 hours. Okay, so once you will be blocking alpha 1, alpha 2, okay, however, it will not block all the receptors. It will be blocking some of the percentage of those receptors. So once it will be blocking that, okay, you will not be able to recover them. So new receptor will be formed after that. Okay, so that is the meaning of irreversible. Then we are having one drug which is the reversible. Okay, rather two drugs we are having. What are these drugs? So one of the category is this one of the category will be this one. Okay, this drug is phentolamine and talazolin. Okay, remember about phentolamine, that is more important. Okay, phentolamine. Now phentolamine is the reversible. Phentolamine is reversible. Now phentolamine is reversible. What does that mean? Which means it will be acting, it will be blocking the alpha 1 as well as alpha 2, but for few hours. For example, 4 to 6 hours. After that, the effect of phentolamine will be diminished. Okay, so that is the difference between these two drugs. So phenoxybenzamine is the irreversible drug and phentolamine is the reversible. So it will be acting for about 4 to 6 hours. Okay, after that the blocking effect will be diminished and the alpha 1 alpha 2 receptors will be free for binding of the adrenaline or noradrenaline. Okay, adrenaline and noradrenaline were the neurotransmitters, they will be binding to them. Good. Now phenoxybenzamine, what is the benefit of using phenoxybenzamine? Phenoxybenzamine, we can use this drug in cases of pheochromocytoma. What is pheochromocytoma? Be more specific. Adrenal gland is having adrenal. Very good. So adrenal gland is having adrenal cortex and medulla. Okay. If your adrenal medulla will be overactivated, in those cases you will be producing what?
Catecholamines.
Right. So catecholamines, and catecholamines include epinephrine and norepinephrine. Okay. Now the amount of the epinephrine, norepinephrine will be increasing. If the amount of epinephrine or norepinephrine, they will be increasing, Okay, they will be activating your sympathetic system or not? Yes. So your sympathetic nervous system will be hyperactivated in those cases. So you need to slow them down. For that, you can use phenoxybenzamine. Okay, you can use phenoxybenzamine. Now phenoxybenzamine, what it will do, it will block the alpha 1 receptor and it will block the alpha 2 receptor. What will be the benefit then? Think about alpha 1 receptor. Alpha 1 receptor we are having on the blood vessels, right? On the blood vessel we are having alpha 1 receptor. If you will block them, which effect will be coming? Vasodilation. Vasodilation. Okay. Fine. Second thing, look, if the sympathetic nervous system will be activating, okay, what will be the effect on your blood pressure? It will be increasing. Okay. So hypertensive situation will be there. You need to decrease it. By blocking the alpha 1, you can achieve that or not?
Yes,
you can achieve that because vasodilation will be happening. Second thing, what will be the beneficial effect? Alpha 2. Now alpha 2, we know we have alpha 2 on the presynaptic. So this is the presynaptic, this is the postsynaptic, and we are having alpha 2 receptors over here. Right? These are the alpha 2. Okay? These are the alpha 2. Okay? Now if you will be blocking alpha 2, what may happen? If for example, clonidine and alpha methyl dopa, they were stimulating them. In these cases, if you will block them, brakes will not be able to apply. Okay? And in those cases, what may happen? More and more amount of. So what was here? This was the presynaptic vesicle, and inside that, what was there? Inside that we were having norepinephrine and all. After that it can come out with the help of exocytosis and all. Okay, so it can come over here, right? Now more amount of epinephrine, more amount of norepinephrine can bind to these receptors. They will be having more chances of that. Okay, so to equalize that effect, okay, we can use phenoxybenzamine. Okay, if in the questions they are asking you about the pheochromocytoma, how you will know that these, what option you may choose, because many drugs will be there, phenoxybenzamine, phentolamine and some other drugs will be there. How to choose, what will be the answer in those cases? You need to identify first of all whether this situation is of pheochromocytoma or not. Then only you can answer phenoxybenzamine. Okay, so what will be the signs in these patients? Those patients who are having the phenoxybenzamine, let's talk about them. Okay, you can remember them with the help of 5P. Okay, so I'm talking about this pheochromocytoma. Okay, how you can remember that with the help of 5Ps. Okay, first of all, they will be having problem with the blood pressure. Okay, so P for blood pressure. Okay. Second thing, they will be having pain. Okay, remember, I'm talking about pheochromocytoma. Pheochromocytoma. And in the pheochromocytoma, catecholamines are increasing very fastly in your blood circulation, right? Which means epinephrine or norepinephrine decreasing. So what will be the effect? Blood pressure will be, should be increasing. There will be the pain. Palpitations. What are palpitations?
During palpitations,
you'll be having tachycardia. Okay, so think about this situation, that if I am sitting right now, I will be having activation of parasympathetic or sympathetic?
Parasympathetic
nervous system. So your heart rate should increase or decrease?
Decrease.
It should decrease. But if you are sitting and at that time you are having tachycardia, is it normal?
No.
It is not normal. That is the palpitation. If you are running at that time, you are having activation of sympathetic, then it's okay that you are having the tachycardia. Then it's okay because of sympathetic nervous system. But if you are sitting, at that time parasympathetic should be activating, but at the same time you are having tachycardia, that is abnormal. Okay, that is the palpitation. Okay, whenever you are feeling your heartbeat while sitting or while you are resting, in that time, that is the palpitation. Okay, fine. What else? Perspiration means
increased rate.
Sweating. Okay, so this person will be sweating. Okay, that is also the sign of pheochromocytoma. And last P is for pallor of the skin. Okay, pallor of the skin. So skin will be pale in color. Okay, so these are the signs by which you can analyze the situation of pheochromocytoma. Okay, so you need to look for these signs in the MCQ if they will be asking about the pheochromocytoma. Once you will be knowing about the situation that this patient is having pheochromocytoma, what will be the drug of choice in that case? Phenoxybenzamine. Okay, one more thing. Non-selective alpha blockers and the selective alpha blockers, both these alpha blockers we can use in the cases of hypertension, right? In both the cases. For severe hypertension, we will use the non-selective alpha blockers. For mild to moderate hypertension, we will be using the selective alpha blockers. Okay, keep that in mind. So in the cases of pheochromocytoma, okay, the person's situation will be severe. Okay, that will be worsening. So in that cases, you will be using the phenoxybenzamine. However, if the patient blood pressure is not that high, for example, it is 145 over 100, for example, okay, that is not that high. Okay, however, this is the case of hypertension. This will be the mild case of hypertension. Okay, in that case, you may use a selective one. Okay, but look for other signs as well. For example, the person is having pain as well. The person is feeling the palpitations. Okay, the person is having the pallor skin, or the person is sweating, he's having perspiration. In that case, which means this is the sign of pheochromocytoma, then this is the severe situation. In those cases, you can use phenoxybenzamine. Okay, if the patient is not having pheochromocytoma, usually we don't use phenoxybenzamine. We are having the selective alpha blockers, or we are having the phentolamine. Okay, what is the benefit of using phentolamine? Because it is reversible. Okay, so you can reverse the situation. If the person is not having pheochromocytoma and you misdiagnose that patient, okay, and you gave what? Phenoxybenzamine. Can you reverse the situation? It will be very difficult for you. Okay, that's why usually we don't use phenoxybenzamine until unless there is a case of pheochromocytoma. Understood? Okay, now let's talk about phentolamine, telazone. We have already talked about that. So mild to moderate, in case of mild to moderate hypertension, we will be using the phentolamine, either telazoline. Okay, phentolamine is quite famous as you compare these drugs. Phentolamine is quite famous if you will be using about the non-selective reversible drug. Okay, fine. Now let's talk about the selective alpha blockers. Okay, selective alpha blockers. Fine. So in the selective alpha blockers, shall I rub this? Okay, let's talk about selective alpha blockers over here. So either you can block alpha 1, okay, either you may block alpha 2, okay. Let's talk about the alpha 1 blockers. Remember about the location of the alpha 1 in your mind, okay. Okay, so alpha 1 blockers, tell me the alpha 1 blocker, that will be the prazosin. Remember, they will be ending with the osin. Okay, so suffix of the alpha 1 blockers will be osin. Okay, so they will be ending with the osin. In your exam, you are finding some drug, you are not able to find out which kind of category is it. Okay, you can remember some drugs with the help of these endings. For example, in antihypertensive, we will be talking about prills, lisinopril and all these things, right? Okay. Lisinopril, captopril. Okay, in those cases, they will be the ACE inhibitors. Okay, then we'll be talking about sartans, that is also antihypertensive category, that is the angiotensin 2 blocker. Okay, we'll be talking about those things later. So after that, we will be talking about the beta blockers, that will be ending with the lol. Okay, for example, atenolol, metoprolol. So some of the drugs you can remember with the help of their suffix. Okay, so alpha 1 blockers, they end with osin. Okay, fine. So prazosin, then you are having doxazosin. Okay, then you are having tarazosin. Okay, so these are some of the drugs. Then you are having tamsulosin also. and psilocin. Okay, so these are the drugs. Look at the ending. So they are ending with osin, right? So these drugs ends with osin. Okay, so prazosin, doxazosin, tarazosin, tamsulosin, psilocin. These are some of the drugs which are the alpha 1 blockers. Now, alpha 1 receptors, if you talk about the subtypes of alpha 1 receptors, okay, we are having subtypes. So these are the alpha 1 A receptor and alpha 1 B receptor. Alpha 1 A receptor and alpha 1 B receptor. Let's talk about the location of alpha 1 A and alpha 1 B, because after knowing the location, it will be very easy for remembering the drug. So alpha 1 receptor is having two subtypes over here. So one is alpha 1 A and one is alpha 1 B. Okay. Now B for blood vessel. B for blood vessel. So in the blood vessel, you will be having alpha 1 B. For alpha 1 A, the location is prostate. Prostate. Where is prostate? In the male reproductive system, prostate gland is there, right? So the location of alpha 1 A receptor is prostate. Okay. Now let me tell you one thing. Prazosin, doxazosin, tarazosin, they can block alpha 1 A receptor as well. They can block alpha 1 B receptor as well. Okay. Prazosin, doxazosin and tarazosin, they can block alpha 1 A receptor as well as alpha 1 B receptor. Look at these drugs, tamsulosin, psilocin. Okay. These drugs will not act on alpha 1 A. These drugs are selectively blocking alpha 1 B. Okay. Sorry, alpha 1 A. Just a sec. Tamsulosin and psilocin, these are selectively, they will be selectively blocking alpha 1 A. They will not be blocking the alpha 1 B. Okay. However, prazosin, doxazosin, tarazosin, they can block alpha 1 A as well as alpha 1 B. Tamsulosin, psilocin, they can block alpha 1 A. What is the use of this thing? Usually we are using them in older age patients. Okay. Now, if you will be visiting the hospital, okay, 60% of the patient, I'm talking about the elder patients, okay, above the age of 50 years or 60 years, most of the patients are having the complaints of hypertension. Most of the patients are having the complaints of hypertension. With that, in most of the cases, I'm talking about 70% of the patients are having blood pressure problem. Okay, with that, they're having the prostate problem. BPH or BHP. BPH is benign prostate hyperplasia. Okay, or you can call that as benign hyperplasia of prostate. Okay, so in most of the patients, they are having the hypertension problem. And they are having the prostate problem. Okay. So, blood pressure is considering with the blood vessel. Right. Prostate is problem with the prostate gland. Right. So, if the elder age patient, okay, I'm not talking about all the patients. Okay. Some of the patient may be having only BP. Some of the patient is having only BPH. Right. But most of the patient, okay, in the wards, they will come, they are usually coming with the both the problems. Okay, so in that case, you don't need to give two different drugs. Only one drug can solve this problem, right? So if you can block the receptor present on the blood vessel, at the same time, if you can block the receptor present on the prostate, you will be solving this problem or not with one drug only. Okay, what is the receptor present over here in the blood vessel? Alpha 1 B. B for blood vessel, B for B receptor, alpha 1 B. What was the receptor on prostate? Alpha 1 A. If you can block alpha 1 A as well as alpha 1 B, you will be resolving this problem. Yes or no? So you can block, you can use which kind of drugs? Prazosin, doxazosin or tarazosin. Okay? With one drug only, you can solve these kind of patients, right? Okay? But there is one problem. What is that problem? If you will give them, because you don't know the patient, they're having the sensitivity, receptor sensitivity, okay? As you grow older, many kind of problems will be coming, okay? What will be happening? Some of the older patients are very, very sensitive to the drugs, okay? So while they are blocking, while you are blocking blood vessel receptors, so for example, you are blocking alpha-1B, and these patients, some of the patients are very, very sensitive to these drugs, okay? If you are blocking, you will be decreasing the blood pressure. In some cases, if the patient is hyperactive, if the receptors are most sensitive, you can give them hypotension because blood pressure will be decreasing drastically in those cases. So hypotension situation. So this is the more common side effect of using these drugs because you are using them in older age patients. Okay. However, if a young patient will be coming, hypotension is quite rare in those cases. But in the some elder age patients, you will be having the problem with the hypotension. Okay. So how you can resolve this problem? You have to give the drug as well. How you can resolve the hypotension problem? Give these drugs. No, but if you will giving selective alpha blockers, what will be the problem? These are selective only, but if you will give, for example, this one, you will not be able to solve blood pressure problem. You will be solving the BPH, but blood pressure problem will be remaining over there. In these cases, if you will be giving these drugs in bad time, whenever the patient is going to sleep now, for example, in the night, before going to bed, give these drugs. Okay? Why I'm saying so? Because if the patient will be having hypotension also, okay, there will be no problem because the patient will be lying on the bed. If you will give this drug in daytime, okay, in the daytime, the person will be not lying on the bed only. They will be walking, they have some work and all these things. If the blood pressure will be lowering in those cases, this person might fall down. Okay? Now the patient is of older age, right? He is having 60 or 65 years of age. You are having more chances of fractures. If the patient will fall, fractures will be there. Now at that age, for the healing of the fractures, it will take much time. So one more problem will be there. Okay? So that's why you have to give these drugs in the bedtime. That is more preferable. That is more preferable. Okay? Talking about those patients who are having only BPH, they're not having blood pressure problem, let's say. Okay, so there is no use of giving these drugs. If the patient is having normal blood pressure, why you are giving this one? You can give this one. So that's why we designed these drugs. Okay, so these drugs, what they will be doing, if the patient is having BPH only, benign prostate, hyperplasia. So if you will be using tamsulosin or silodosin, okay, what will be the effect? They can block the receptors present on the prostate. That will be the alpha-1A. And with that, you can resolve the problem of benign prostate hyperplasia. Okay, so that is the significance of designing these drugs, that whether they can block alpha-1A or alpha-1B. Okay, because most of the patients' problem will be solved by these drugs because they will be resolving the blood pressure problem, hypertension problem. At the same time, they can resolve the prostate problems. Okay. That's why. Fine, so you understood about the alpha-1 blockers, selective alpha-1 blockers. Everybody? Okay, let's talk about the alpha-2 blockers. Alpha-2 blockers we usually do not use because